According to the SLTU's president, Don Howard, the body of educators is concerned about the implementation of plans for the return of students to school on Monday, January 11th. Decisions, he says, have been made without consultation with the SLTU, demonstrating a lack of empathy and respect for teachers and their contribution to education in St. Lucia.
For instance, in a pandemic, we understand that this is a major health and safety issue. And the provisions that were previously in place, which would have provided a perfect opportunity for deep sanitization, the ministry unilaterally removed it. And they are refusing to even listen to the professionals on the ground. In a pandemic, by the actions, suggests that they are now placing lesser emphasis on deep sanitization. And that is a major concern.
Referencing the continuity of education plan, Howell pointed out that it was through the continuous urging of the organization that this plan even came into being. The SLTU is not the first to raise concerns about adequate stakeholder engagement when it comes to decisions taken by the ministry. Earlier this week, the National Association of Early Childhood Practitioners accused the ministry of sidelining the private preschools and not consulting them in the formulation of the continuity of education plan.
The SLTU would like to call on the Ministry of Education to correct some of the circumstances and situations that they are creating in schools that provide even more strain for teachers, because teaching and online and face-to-face demands a lot more from teachers. And we would like the Ministry of Education as well to desist from belittling the contribution made by our principals and teachers.
Teachers, says Howell, are putting their health and safety and that of their families at risk by returning to the physical classroom, and they are only doing so because they care for their students. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.